everyone, for coming out. I'm really excited about tonight because this is actually my first paid concert. So I'm excited to see the fourth and fifth graders. They've put in a ton of work over the last 2 months with Mrs. Conrad. They had an 8 a.m. performance this morning. They did a great job on that, so I know they're going to be great tonight as well. And they come over at 1 o'clock this afternoon. They also practice here. They should do a great job for you tonight. I just want to thank everyone. It's been a great start to the year. I love being part of this supportive community. We've had a lot of stuff happening at the school with game night. We have a lock-in tomorrow. We've done a lot of celebrations for positive behavior. So again, I'm just beyond myself about being part of this community. As far as tonight, Mrs. Conrad is going to take over. But just sit back and relax. Like I said, it was really good this morning, and I'm anxious for you guys to hear.
Thank you all for coming out to support your children. They have worked very hard getting this program ready for you. And we are doing a little bit of a different format tonight in that each grade level or each group is doing like a small play. So there will be boys and girls coming to the microphones with speaking parts. And so I hope you will all refrain from conversing with your neighbors in between songs so that we can hear all of our dialogue. The kids have worked very hard to learn the dialogue. And please remember to turn off all your cell phones. Hope you enjoy our evening of Broadway. Thank you so much.
No. The time is 1930 and the state orphanage. In New York City, a couple of young girls are dreaming of what it would be like to have parents come and get them.
Miss Hannigan will catch you.
I don't care. I'm getting out of here.
Ha! Caillou, now make this stump shine like the top of the Chrysler building.
Mm-hmm. like there's never any light.
Once a day, don't you wanna throw the towel in? It's easier than putting up a fight.
Santa Claus, what's that? Who's he?
No one cares for you a smidge when you're in an orphanage.
It's a hard knock life, it's a hard knock life. It's a hard knock life.
While everyone at the orphanage was busy cleaning, Annie escaped to New York City.
You seen any stray dogs around here?
No, sir.
Good, then they must all be running wild on Rue Street's over.
Hey, there's one they didn't get. They're after you, ain't they? Well, they're after me, too. I won't let them get you. If not today, well...
Come here.
Yes, officer?
You're the one of my orphan. Miss Hannigan reported. Come with me. I'm taking you back.
Lieutenant Ward took Annie back to the orphanage. That afternoon, the orphanage received an unusual visitor.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yes?
I'm Grace Farrell, private secretary of Oliver Warbucks.
Oliver Warbucks, the millionaire?
No, Oliver Warbucks, the billionaire. Mr. Warbucks has decided to invent an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays at his home.
What sort of orphan did he have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and cheerful. Oh, I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers a red-headed child.
A cheerful redhead? Sorry, we don't have any kind of orphans like that.
But Grace insisted that Annie be the chosen orphan.
And Annie was off to the Warbucks mansion.
Welcome to the Warbucks Mansion. Good afternoon, Miss Farrell.
Good afternoon, Drake. Everyone, this is Annie and her dog, Sandy. Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
And what would you like to do first?
The floors, I'll scrub them first, then I'll get to the windows.
Annie, you don't have to do any cleaning. You're our guest.
And for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time now.
Where is everybody? Hello, everybody. Drake, dismiss the staff.
Yes, sir.
Well, Annie, we ought to do something special on our first night. Would you like to go to a movie?
Gosh, Mr. Warbucks, I never been to one before.
Drake?
Yes, sir.
Get our coats. We're going to the movies.
Leaping lizards.
Which call we be wanting today, sir?
This child has been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
Oliver Warbucks and Grace showed Annie a part of New York she'd never known before.
This was the beginning of many adventures for little orphan Annie.
The nation may have been depressed that Christmas of 1933.
But Annie gave everyone she met, rich or poor, the gift of hope and goodwill.
Hey, hobo man, hey, Dapper man.
by the name of Hill.
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 No.
No, he doesn't know the territory.
Doesn't know the territory?
Look, what do you talk? What do you talk? What do you talk?
He's a music man, and he sells clarinets to the kids in the town with the big trombones and the rat-a-tat drums and the big brass bass, big brass bass.
Well, I don't know much about bands, but I do know you can make a living selling big trombones. No, sir.
No, this fella sells bands. Boys' bands. I don't know how he does it, but he lives like a king. And when the man dances...
Certainly, boys. What else?
The piper pays him.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But he...
Yes, sir.
But he doesn't know the territory.
Harold Hill ventured out into the small town, River City, Iowa, to try his luck.
River City, Iowa. Gentlemen, you intrigue me. I think I'll give Iowa a try.
Don't believe I caught your name.
Don't believe it? I dropped it.
Harold Hill was surprised to run into his old buddy Marcellus Washburn.
What are you doing here? You're not back in the band business.
Yup.
But you don't know anything about music.
Marcellus, stop worrying.
We got a lazy music teacher who'll expose you before you get your bags unpacked.
She passes by, point her out to me.
I will.
May I have your attention, please? Attention, please. I can deal with this trouble, friends, with the wave of my hand, this very hand. Please observe me, if you will. I'm Professor Harold Hill, and I'm here to organize the River City's boys' band. Oh, a band will do it, my friends. Oh, yes, I mean a boys' band. Can you hear me? I say River City's gotta have a boys' band, and I mean she needs it today. Well, Professor Harold Hill's on hand, and River City's gonna have that boys' band, and that band's gonna be in uniform.
Famous man, 76 trombones cut the horn.
The mayor wasn't buying Harold Hill's remedy for the town's trouble.
Gentlemen of the school board, this calls for emergency action. This man is a spellbinder. Find out if he ever got his college music degree.
Harold Hill evaded the school board's request for his degree by teaching them the joy of singing and harmony.
But some of the ladies were suspicious too.
Not the long lady who teaches the piano. Marion Prue, I believe. Well, after all, she is the librarian.
She must have picked him up the first cuck out of the box.
Shouldering up to a man like that.
I saw him talking to her.
Brazen!
Pick a little, talk a lot.
Cheep, cheep, cheep.
Professor, her kind of woman doesn't belong on any committee. Of course I shouldn't tell you this, but she advocates dirty books.
Chaucer!
Rabelais.
Balzac.
And the worst thing, of course I shouldn't tell you this.
The man lived down my street. Let me tell.
Stop! I'll tell. She made brazen overtures to a man who didn't have a friend in this town, old Miser Madison.
Miser Madison? Madison Picnic Park? Madison Gymnasium? Madison Hospital? That Miser Madison?
Exactly. Who do you think it was anyway?
Well, I should say, the show-off. He gave the town a library too, didn't he?
When he died, he left the library building to the city.
But he left all the books to her.
Harold Hill continued to sell instruments to all the boys in town.
And he kept escaping the school's board request for his credentials.
Harold Hill was trying so hard to convince everyone that he was a real band director and that he made up a song about his hometown, Gary, Indiana.
Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, let me say you once again. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, that's the town that knew me when. If you like to have a logical explanation, how I happened on this elegant syncopation, I will say without a moment of hesitation, there is just one place that can light my face. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, not Louisiana, Paris, France, New York, or Rome. Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, Gary, Indiana, my home sweet home.
Marianne, the music teacher, was suspicious of Harold Hill, too.
Marianne, now what are you up to?
I have a feeling the Indiana Journal may help me poke some holes in the professor's claims.
Marianne found some interesting information about Harold Hill's background at the library.
He couldn't have graduated from college in Gary, Indiana in 05 because the town wasn't even built in 06.
The Wells Fargo wagon is just coming up from the depot.
At this hour of day?
It could be the band instruments.
The band instruments? I want the man's credentials.
Wells Fargo wagon is a coming down the street. Oh, please let it be for me. Oh, the Wells Fargo wagon is a coming down the street. I wish I knew what it could be.
I got a box of maple sugar on my birthday.
In March I got a Gray Mackinac.
And once I got some grapefruit from Tampa.
And Montgomery got me salmon in a cross-cut saw.
Wells Fargo wagon is a coming down the street. I wish it was like
a candy. It could be curtains or dishes or a double boiler, or it could be.
Yes, sir, it surely could be
something special.
Something very, very special now,
just for me.
Coming down the street, oh, don't let him pass my door. Oh, the Wells Fargo wagon is a coming down the street. I wish I knew what it could be.
I got some salmon from Seattle last September,
and I expect a new rocking chair.
I hope I get my raisins from Fresno.
The DAR has sent a cannon for the courthouse square.
Oh, the Wells Fargo wagon is coming now. How can I ever wait to see? It could be thumping for someone who is no relation, or it could be something special just for me.
Wells Fargo wagon is a coming. Oh, the Wells Fargo wagon is a coming. Oh, the Wells Fargo wagon, don't you dare to make a stop till you stop for me.
Here you are, Winthrop.
My cornet. Gee, thanks, Professor.
Round one for you, Mr. Hill, but I better hear some tooing out of those horns in pretty short order.
Marianne can see how happy Winthrop was, all because of Harold Hill's band.
In fact, the spirits of every person in River City had been lifted.
Harold Hill might have not come to River City to sell people something they didn't need, but what he gave them was the inspiring gift of music.
Rose of the green of every famous band.
all my life until this very moment. I was nothing, and now I'm alive.
If it could only happen to me. Kim, where did he pin you?
On the bus. Bless that yellow school bus. I've got to go.
Yeah, hang up so I can spread the word.
Hi, Nancy.
Hi, Helen.
What's the story? Morning glory.
What's the tale? Morning glory.
Tell me quick about Hugo and Kim.
Hi, Margie.
Hi, Alice.
What's the story? Morning glory.
We're hummingbird.
Have you heard about Hugo and Kim?
Did you hear them cry? Did you hear them cry? Or was he too shy? What had it happened? I was hoping they would. Now they're living at last. Going steady for good.
Hello, Mrs. Hinkle. This is Harvey Johnson. Can I speak to Penelope Ann?
Is it true about Kim?
Can I
just know it somehow.
About the prom.
Must call her right up.
On Saturday?
I can talk to you now.
Johnson, can I speak to Deborah Sue?
Well, I heard they got pinned.
Deborah?
I was hoping they would.
Saturday?
Now that they've been at last.
Are you free?
Going steady for good.
Is Charity home from school yet?
Did they really get pinned?
Charity?
I was thinking they would.
Are you free on Saturday?
No, living at last.
On the prom?
Stay for good.
While everyone was on the phone about Kim and Hugo, Conrad Birdie's manager was trying to get through Sweet Apple, Ohio.
Conrad Birdie is a big rock star who has been just drafted into the Army.
Kim had just been chosen to give Conrad a farewell kiss on the Ed Sullivan Show.
You'd put me on Ed Sullivan?
Oh, I'd die.
Ed Sullivan, he's my favorite human. That's why I decided to let Kim go on in the first place. Ed Sullivan, me appearing with Ed Sullivan,
Ed Sullivan,
Ed Sullivan, we're gonna
Got a wonderful wife, two swell kids, a good business, and now this.
With Conrad's visit to the Sweet Apple, Albert and his secretary, Rosie, had a misunderstanding.
Rose wasn't speaking to Albert, and Albert was doing his best to put on a happy face, her happy face.
It's been a long time since people have existed that parents and teenagers have difficulty understanding each other.
Doris! Doris, do you like it? Isn't it exciting?
No, I told you not to dye your hair.
But I want to. Isn't it just a gas?
You dare defy your mother?
It's my hair.
Not till you're 21.
What's the matter?
Young lady, stay in your room till it changes back. Do you hear me?
I won't.
I demand respect around here.
It's my hair.
Respect. Do you hear me? Respect.
Talk and talk till your face is blue. Kids, but the
Of course, the kids in Conrad had their own way, had their own ways of getting their frustrations out from their parents.
Man, Albert has so many rules. I'm so stressed. I have to get out of here.
I know. My parents are such squares, and Hugo has been such a dweeb of your being here.
Hey, Hugo, what do you cats do around here for fun?
Well, there's the burger joint on Main Street or the bowling alley, but all the really cool chicks and guys hang out at the ice house.
The Ann Sullivan Show has had several things go wrong.
Conrad does not get to bestow his farewell kiss on Kim.
Rose and Albert make up.
Hugo and Kim make up, and Conrad goes off to Army.
You come.
While I thank your parents for coming out to support us this evening, we have had a great time getting this program ready for you. Hope you have enjoyed it, and we're going to finish up our program with the Lullaby of Broadway.
I just want, oh, that is good, isn't it? I just want to say congratulations to the fourth and fifth grade. That was a great job tonight. You guys can all give yourself a round of applause. That was amazing. I talked for a long time with this. And I also want to thank Mrs. Conrad. I have no idea how she could put all this together and remember all of it, because I know that I couldn't. Fourth and fifth grade, though, again, great job. And I'm gonna give Mrs. Conrad her flowers for tonight. And I want everyone to get home safe, and thank you for coming out.